You unlock this door with the key of imagination. Beyond it is another dimension. A dimension of sound. A dimension of sight. A dimension of mind. You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
It is 11:11 p.m., October 31st, 2016, here on the South Side of Chicago. What we are looking at is another case of teenage stress. We have Randy, a high school sophomore at Urban Prep. It may appear Randy is sleeping, but in fact, Randy is a victim of yet another tragic case of teenage stress. Not only having three exams today in school, but a final project in his English course and a test in his AP class. Randy suffers from an overload and fatigue. Participating in school sports, maintaining a part-time job, and keeping his grades has resulted in teenage stress. Sad, but yet another fatality due to extreme teenage stress. Another case of teenage stress. What did it? Well, you see here, Amy goes to school downtown and travels all the way from her house on the south side. Just last week, Amy lost a best friend in a drive-by shooting. She has been dealing with the pain of her lost friend without any experience in death before. Her grades are falling behind because she spent most of her time crying or thinking about her now past friend. What caused her to finally reach teenage stress? The constant nagging of her mom, Tasha. How is Amy to focus and be happy in and out of school, expected to complete chores and classwork? Is there any cure for teenage stress? We have come upon another yet case of teenage stress, with a broken heart being the culprit. Jordan had to take care of her little brother Josh, work two jobs, and maintain high grades in school. Along with this, as you can see, Jordan is waiting for the bus texting her boyfriend, Brian. Jordan grows increasingly frustrated with every text sent. Little does she know, Brian is walking down 47th Street with Taylor, a girl he met at school.